Good day, fellas. I hope you are ready for your daily dose of skill, and today we are going to play with Progetto 46. In my opinion, one of the better premium tanks, and looks like recently this tank was on sale, so I believe quite some of you picked one, this vehicle. And once again, is it worth it? I think the tank is very, very good, fellas, but ask yourself, how much do you enjoy the game before opening your wallet? Because I know a handful examples of skill, I hate the game, but I will take two Progetto. Skill, I hate the game, but give me 1 year of premium days. That's what I want to say. And now, without further ado, I believe we can go into the battle with this vehicle and we'll see how the things will look like. I have a feeling, boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen, the maxi map is going to be a bit smaller in this video because I did not install it a scale mode yet in the EU server. So what that means map is going to be a bit smaller, but it is not going to be a big problem, at least I hope so. And for our next video, you are going to have the proper settings and everything is going to be Gucci. It is just a heads up for you. And probably the biggest enemy of Progetto, or I suppose to say the rival of Progetto, would be Borat. What do I mean by saying this? I mean, Borat is extremely powerful tank and Progetto is powerful tank. And I believe there is two camps. People which love Progetto and people which love Borat. And if you love Borat, you won't say Progetto is that great as Borat is, and vice versa. So yeah, this is the thing. Okay, first battle. Tier 8, Kempinovka. Very nice. Okay, what is the plan, what is the hope, and what is the dream, and what do we want to do, fellas? And by the way, like I said before, you see, the tanks is a bit smaller, and the map is a bit smaller, but I believe, boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen, we will survive this for one video. It probably can affect phone users, right? If you are in the bed before falling asleep, you are pretty much watching the video, yeah. I believe there is a chance it is not going to be as great as it is usually. But it's okay. So, what is the plan, what is the hope, and what is the dream? I have a feeling they have a person in the typical bush. Right there. Let's check it out. Definitely not a direct hit. Definitely not a direct hit. Definitely not a direct hit. Okay, never mind. Everything is Gucci. Everything is fine. I really needed to test out... to check it out. Are we hitting someone or not? This is very, very important. This is extremely important. Okay. Look, looking into amount of the guns which we have, it is completely fine. I believe we should be able to make it work. Question is, how many guns enemies will have? Beautiful. This Fava is horrible tank, I repeat, this Fava is absolutely horrible. So what we need to do? We need to try to penetrate him in the face. Unfortunately, when he is using a bit of the gun depression, it is not looking that great as I would love to, but we are okay. We need to wait until the big boys will arrive. And here you go. Our big boys are arriving. Beautiful. That's what I need and that's what I am looking for. Do I want to take a bottom part? Okay, this is not great. Listen, fellas, I am doing way too many mistakes. The thing is, I do not really have armor with Progetto, and going on top of the hill, yeah, I get it. It is optimistical choice and everything. If the things are going well, you know, we can get some use. But I changed my mind. It's not really worth it. I'm taking way too much damage, literally for free. So, instead of doing that, we are going to try to beat the living crap out of Progetto or out of this light tank which is sitting in the back. Such a hard start for us. Such a hard start for us. I'm a bit sad about this, but it is how it is. So no complaints, no regrets, fellas. I am getting spotted all the time. Huh. Oh, you sneaky bastard. Oh, you sneaky, sneaky, sneaky little bastard. Wow. This M41D. Wow. He is playing well, fellas. He is playing very, very well. Wow, I did not saw that one coming, but it is completely fine. It is how it is. No complaints, no regrets. We still can make this battle up to 4,000 combined, I believe. And yes, start might be not the best. Oh, this is exactly what we needed. Start might be not the best, but we are going to make it work. Skill, what you are going to do next? The thing is, next mission for us will be to take this position right here. And from this position, we are going to start countering this Progetto. Trust me on this one. We are feeling very, very well, and life is definitely beautiful, fellas. Look at this. Soon, this Progetto will change his mind and he will say, why the flying fluff I am playing here? Watch this. And one. And two. Good. Very nice, fellas. We are sitting very, very well. Look, there is no artist who could counter us, so we are feeling great, and now Progetto is thinking, aha! Aha! And Progetto is going to the garage. Beautiful. This is exactly what we needed to do, and this is exactly what we was dreaming about doing. And now we need to get a bit involved here. Skill, what exact position do you want to take? I want to go like this more likely. And from now on, we will try to clip this gentleman out. Hopefully it will work. Beautiful. 2 out of 3 is not horrible, but it could be definitely better. It is fine, fellas. It is fine. What is the next step for us? The next step for us, I don't really think I want to be involved that much. Why so? The thing is, they have a full forest full of bush campers, right? It is completely fine. This is how you are defending this game, though. So we can't say, how dare they to camp in the back. This is the right way to play Campinovka. And if you are having a safe defense parameter in Alpha 4, Alpha 5, you pretty much cannot outplay them. I mean, how you can go and deal with them? This is not so simple, fellas. Keep this in mind. This is not so simple. Okay, so what do we want to do now? Now we are going to be a bit involved against this CS. Ooh, wow, you little mosquito. That was a good bush. Fellas, that was a good bush. And I was blind firing this bush quite a bit. Huh. Interesting. Very interesting. Alright, so what is the next plan for us and what do we want to do? We want to get involved against this CS-53. By the way, who doesn't know, CS-53 is one of the worst tier 8 tanks in the game. So it is completely... Fine, we should be able to beat the living crap out of him without even asking his name. That's one. Now he is getting involved. Okay, he changed his mind. That's excellent. That was pretty bad shot by me. Nothing what I could do about this. And now we are going to wait until I will fully reload. Whenever I will fully reload, we are going to eliminate him from the game just like so. Beautiful. Now, next thing, Centurion 5/1. Can we find a decent angle for this gentleman? I think our team is going to be completely fine. I believe so. Mm-hmm. Okay, how to approach enemies? How to approach enemies? This is the question. Ooh, that was a good play by this mother trucker. That was a good play by the Centurion. It is okay. Yeah, we lost quite a bit of HP and everything, but it's fine. You see, fellas, we had such a horrible start of this battle, and look what kind of end result we are having, and we are not even done yet. There is still a lot of things for us to do. For example, to find this TS5 and get shit ton of assisting damage, or to burst this T32 in the butt. So yeah, I am pretty happy about my progression and about my decision in this game. Good. Good. I said good. Very nice. And TS5, that's it. Look, we are going to burst the living crap out of his ass and we are going to be completely fine. Very well played for our 274. Oh, you son of the banana. I can't stand people which... Oh, that's quite sad. I cannot stand people who are saying, well, we are losing the game, so I want to drown myself. This is not very nice and this is not very good, but that's what we have. Still, nevertheless, extremely good game. I am happy how I played this battle, and I know I have made a mistake in the start of the game to go on top of the hill. I truly did, but in the end of the day, we have a great performance. Very nice. 5,000 combined for our mate. Good. We are top by the damage. We are second by experience and very, very well deserved. 274 did a great job. And this is what we have. Very nice. Beautiful. Speaking about the profits, we made 92,000 profits. Not counting the... obviously not counting the mission credits. So, let's go. First game done. Beautiful. Can we get another game like Prokhorovka? I mean, for the sake of love, Prokhorovka sounds good, don't you think so? Let's see. Looking into my credits, fellas, we have 113, 113, 221. Holy bananas. Such a beautiful number. Very nice. And once again, what I have done in the previous game, I believe I could do kind of similar things with Borat 2, although Borat gun handling is a bit different story. Borat gun handling can work very, very well, and in the same time, Borat gun handling can treat you like a pile of kaku, and unfortunately, nothing what you can do about this. So, speaking about Progetto, it's more reliable, speaking about the gun accuracy. Plus, on top of that, you don't need to shoot all three shells. You can shoot one, wait, shoot twice, wait once again, and keep shooting, you know? This is the thing. This is the thing. So, what is the plan and what do we want to do? What do we want to do? I believe we want to take a typical bush here, and from this typical bush we should be able to spot enemies who are crossing. Let's see. No. Tiger 2. Bam. Bam. Very nice. I am just waiting patiently till someone else will join this lemming train in the city in a way. Although I must admit one thing, fellas, looks like we should make more pressure to the city. At least that's what I want to believe, fellas. I think we need to make more pressure to the city. So let's go. The biggest threat for me and the biggest problem is my X50-100. I definitely do not want to meet this gentleman, because if he is catching me on track, I'm pretty much doomed. But what I want to do, I want to beat the living crap out of this tiger, and believe me, we will. Unlucky for this poor soul. I mean, he had such a fun game. Shame, but shit happens. Nothing what he can change about this. Our Škoda will get beaten by the AMX. I really want to help our friend, but it is not so simple, or is it? Okay, you know what? This guy is on the reload. What that basically means? That basically means... He is baboon! Fellas, he is baboon! Greetings to you, comrade. I love you too. I love you too. That's a nice dance. Fellas, I just can't hit baboon. I can't. There are some things which I cannot do, and hitting baboon when baboon has the PP raised and whenever he is dancing, I just can't, okay? I just cannot, fellas. Okay, what do we want to do now? We want to start making that's a nice PP raised. That's a nice PP raised. What do we want to do now? We want to eliminate Borats from the game, if it is possible, obviously. This is very, very important, fellas. Let's see. And Borat. Mm-hmm. Oi. Yep, that's a mistake from my side. Nothing what I can change about this. That was so stupid. Okay, so once again, you see that danger of enemy Borat? Enemy Borat can burst pretty much 720 damage in 2 seconds. And I definitely made a mistake. 2 Borats, I am instantly dead, pretty much. 2 Borats, I am dead. It doesn't matter do I have full HP or not. So that's on me, not a big deal. I was aggressive. I made a mistake and I got punished for my stupidity. That's completely fine, fellas. I am feeling relatively alright with this. So, let's teleport into the end of this game. Let's do this. And we are back with a victory. Not a big surprise. This is a typical Ensk battle, fellas. Ensk is very tiny map, so you cannot expect Ensk games to be 10 minutes long. This game was like, what, 4 minutes? Yeah, this is a typical in the current situation, and you need to figure out how to be aggressive and how not to get slaughtered, because in this kind of situation, fellas, we were aggressive, but in the same time, we got slaughtered too, so that's no bueno. But it is how it is. 1.2000 damage, 400 assisting damage, definitely not great. Bad. We are in the 8th position, if I am not mistaken, by the damage. We are in 7th position by experience. Not a great round. And once again, Borats just simply clipped the living hell out of me, and I cannot do anything about this. And once again, that's fine. It is good showcase. Progetto is not really extremely easy tank to play. In other words, whenever you are going to make a mistake, you are definitely going to get punished for for it, right? It's not like you are playing cover 4. With a cover 4, you have armor, you have a Russian troll factor. With Progetto, you do not have that. But, in other words, Progetto has a great carry potential, especially if you know how to play with the glass cannons. Okay, what do we have now? We have Glacier, very, very good. So what do we want to do in this game? In this game, we want to go into the middle, and hopefully from the middle, we will be able to clip some guys, some bushwankers here, or alternatively, someone who are playing in the middle. Let's do this. Mm-hmm. I would love to get 4,000 combined in this game. That's what I want, fellas. That's what I want. 4,000 combined. Am I asking too much? Actually, you know what? I am going to take this position. Maybe it is going to be even better for us. Light tank, hello. That's 1 for a light tank. That's 2 for a light tank. Beautiful punishment. Very nice. And plus on top of that, we have another light who is trying to go on top of the hill. And we cannot allow him to go there. We cannot allow him to go there, fellas. It is very, very bad if he is going to go up. So we are finishing him off. Beautiful. And that's what we have. Borat is thinking about being involved. This is not the smartest. Oh, Borat. My friend Borat, I love you. Please don't judge me. I sincerely apologize. Okay, Borat is baboon. I repeat, Borat is baboon. I mean, how I supposed to know? You see, this is a very tricky situation for me whenever I'm playing the game, because I am not shooting guys who are raising the guns, right? It is like a meme of the stream and everything, so I simply cannot slaughter person if he is on the ground and he is saying, "Hey, skill, hey." I just can't do so. It is not nice from my side. That would be simply low, right? And I can tell you one thing. I can appreciate a nice dance of baboon. I can promise you that, fellas. Okay, Trash 103 is getting slaughtered. Motion. Good, very good. And what do we have? Progetto here, doesn't really matter. Okay, wait for it. 1. 2. Beautiful. And once again, what we will try to do in this position, we are just waiting until the ball breaker will try to cross like this. Whenever ball breaker will try to cross like this, we are going to make sure he is not going to enjoy his experience. And once again, we just need to be patient, fellas. All we need to do, we need to be patient. Come on. Come on, big boy. Just cross. Just cross, big boy. By the way, we are winning this battle already by quite a big margin, so I would love to figure out how to get a bit more involved into this. Now I want to check out, do they have Progetto? Oh yes, they do have Progetto. Very nice. How about the same motion? Motion is not making pressure. Actually, ball breaker. I'm mixing those two tanks. How to get involved and how to get more use. Opa. This is risky because they have Ude sniper. And more likely I will take one for the team from the Udes. Ude should sit somewhere here. I am pretty sure about this. Okay, watch this. Now we are going to go for enemy Progetto. Good, that's completely fine. You think I am feeling bad? No, no, no. I am feeling very good. I should be able to cross by taking only one for the team. Beautiful. Module 1 is hitting us for once. Doesn't really matter. I want to boost the score up to 4,000, fellas. So, in a way, this is a risky decision we are making. But in the same time, we need to get a bit more involved if we want to get more use, if you know what I mean. So I wish to say everything would be so simple, but unfortunately it is not the case. Meanwhile, look at this gentleman. How are you doing? He just fired. So what we are going to do, we are going to clip his ass like there is no tomorrow. He is dead. Great. Now whenever we are going to reload, we are going... Actually, you know what? Reloading? What do you mean? What do you mean reloading? Bam. Aww. Okay, never mind. I thought, boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen, we are going to be able to ram him to death, but the hashtag never like it. Now, watch this. We know where Udes is. Udes is having a great time while sitting in the back. So my goal is to get good speed, clip him and ram him to death. Let's see, can we do this? Because Udes is made out of paper for obvious reasons. He doesn't have a great armor. And you know what? No, 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 no. Holy bananas from Banana Land. Stop running, you mother trucker. Stop running. Policeman officer skill, stop. You are speeding. Udes, stop, you are speeding. Oh yes, boy! I said stop, otherwise I need to ram your vehicle. I said stop, sir. Okay, nice. Look at this. It was once again quite a quick blitz game. 3,000 damage, 1,000 assisting damage, or close to 1,000 assisting damage. It wasn't a bad game by any means, and I am feeling very happy with my performance. Well, the second battle was bad, but once again, mistakes were made, so I can't complain too much about this, don't you think so? So we are feeling fine. Second class, once again, 3,000 damage, 900 assisting damage. We are top by experience. We are top by the damage. We have done a good things. We made 90,000 profits, obviously, without any boosters, although consumables are not counted because I'm buying consumables on the discount. And skill, how many consumables do you have? Fellas, I can tell you one thing. The best way to save credits in World of Tanks is just to be a cheap bastard and to buy the things when they are on the discount. For example, we have top of the tree Vaza. Buy those tanks on the discount. We have IS-4 line. Buy those tanks on the discount. Simple as this. And speaking about extra rations, how many extra rations do we have, fellas? I have quite a big stock of them, and I am always buying them whenever we are having a discounts, right? I am trying to keep them around 1000 mark, unless there is a line which I don't need to play that much. For example, Progetto line, we have 400 extra rations and it is completely fine, and that's how am I doing the things. Anyways, score with a Progetto, we did 2,600 damage and we did 700 assisting damage. Not that great considering my average score of Progetto, but in the same time, once again, one game in best out of three and the score is significantly going down. So once again, I am not feeling too bad about this. So fellas, thank you very much for watching. I hope you had a great time and you enjoyed yourself. And one more thing which I need to ask, what do you think about Progetto? Maybe you can recommend that for a player who doesn't have it, and do you should he buy this or not? Or maybe you cannot stand Progetto, so feel free to share your opinion together with us. It is going to take 10 seconds for you, and it would maybe someone would change his mind instead of buying the tank, or instead of saving money. So feel free to share your opinion. Anyways, fellas, thank you very much for watching. That was your daily dose of skill, and skill is out. See you next time. Peace.